हेलो एवरीवन, वेलकम टू वीडियो लेक्चर ऑन ट्रांसपोर्ट फिनोमेना। माय सेल्फ खुशभूषा, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर इन केमिकल इंजीनियरिंग डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ एलजे इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ इंजीनियरिंग एंड टेक्नोलॉजी। इन आवर प्रीवियस लेक्चर वी हैव स्टार्टेड चैप्टर नंबर 1 व्हिच इज इंट्रोडक्शन टू ट्रांसपोर्ट फिनोमेना। इन दैट लेक्चर वी हैव ऑलरेडी सीन व्हाट आर द क्लासिफिकेशन ऑफ ट्रांसपोर्ट प्रोसेस एंड what are the three different levels at which we can apply the transport phenomena. At that time I have told you that at three different level the conservation laws play an important role. So let's start this session with that topic, which is conservation laws. Conservation law plays a key role when we are studying the three different levels of the transport phenomena. What are that three different levels? Microscopic level, microscopic level and molecular level. When we study that three different level, at that time the conservation laws plays a key role. Let's see what the conservation law is. We will study three types of the conservation laws in transport phenomena course. What are that three conservation laws? Law of conservation of mass, law of conservation of energy and law of conservation of momentum. Again here we are connecting the three topics. From the first session I have told you that the subject is the combination of three subjects. Transport phenomena is the combination of fluid dynamics, heat transfer and mass transfer. So that's why we are considering these three laws: law of conservation of momentum, law of conservation of energy and law of conservation of mass. So let's see these three laws in detail. First is the law of conservation of mass. We already know what is the law of conservation of mass, but here I am repeating to revise this. During any chemical reaction, the total mass and number of atoms of the reactant equals the total mass and number of atoms of products. This is the statement of law of conservation of mass. What it states? Law of conservation of mass states that during chemical reaction, total mass and number of atoms of reactants is equal to total mass and number of atoms of product. That is the statement of the law of conservation of mass. Let's take one example. See, here you can see 2 mole of Na plus 2 mole of H2O combines and it will give you 2 moles of NaOH plus 1 mole of H2. But while you are taking summation of different atoms, see, for example Na, in reactant what is the total number of atom of Na? That is 2. While we are comparing it with the product, see here, 2 atoms of Na. So in reactant total number of atom is equal to reactant product total number of Na. Similarly, if you see the total number of atom of H2, or I can say hydrogen H, what it will be in the reactant? 4, and in product here in 2 in NaOH and 2 in separate. So total number of hydrogen atom is 4 in reactant as well as in product. So I can say that this example gives you the knowledge of law of conservation of mass. Total number and total mass of the reactant is equal to total mass and total number of atom in product. So this is about the law of conservation of mass. Let's see another conservation law, law of conservation of energy. What it states? The law of conservation of energy states that the energy can neither be created nor destroyed. वी ऑल नो दीज लॉ, राइट? एनर्जी कैन नाइदर बी क्रिएटेड नॉट डिस्ट्रॉयड, ओनली कन्वर्टेड फ्रॉम वन फॉर्म ऑफ एनर्जी टू अनदर फॉर्म. वी कैन चेंज द फॉर्म ऑफ एनर्जी बट वी कैन नॉट क्रिएट और वी कैन नॉट डिस्ट्रॉय द एनी फॉर्म ऑफ एनर्जी. सो दैट इज द स्टेटमेंट ऑफ द लॉ. सो द लॉ ऑफ कंजर्वेशन ऑफ एनर्जी स्टेट्स दैट एनर्जी कैन नाइदर बी क्रिएटेड नॉट डिस्ट्रॉय, ओनली कन्वर्टेड फ्रॉम वन फॉर्म ऑफ एनर्जी टू अनदर फॉर्म ऑफ एनर्जी. दिस मीन्स दैट द सिस्टम ऑलवेज हैज सेम अमाउंट ऑफ एनर्जी. मे बी द फॉर्म इज डिफरेंट बट द अमाउंट ऑफ एनर्जी रिमेन्स सेम. लेट्स सी वन एग्जाम्पल. सी हियर, इन दिस एग्जाम्पल यू कैन अंडरस्टैंड दैट व्हेन वी आर, फॉर एग्जाम्पल दिस इज अ सॉलिड बॉडी, व्हेन वी आर मूविंग इट फ्रॉम वन साइड टू अनदर साइड, वी आर थ्रोइंग इट फ्रॉम वन साइड टू अनदर साइड, दैट मीन्स वी आर चेंजिंग द फॉर्म ऑफ एनर्जी. द काइनेटिक एनर्जी इज चेंजिंग इन द फॉर्म ऑफ पोटेंशियल एनर्जी. यू कैन सी द हाइट इज सेम ऑन बोथ द साइड, that means the energy remains same but the form of energy is different. You can very well understand from the figure. The kinetic energy is changing to potential energy but the amount of energy remains same. Fine. So that's the law says energy can neither be created nor destroyed but it can be converted from one form of energy to another form. That means here in this example we are changing the form of energy from kinetic energy to potential energy but the amount of energy remains same. So that's the law of conservation of energy. And the last is law of conservation of momentum. The law of conservation of momentum states that the total momentum of two objects, total momentum of two objects before collision is equal to total momentum of two objects after collision. That's the law states. Fine. If we are combining or if we collide the two objects, at that time the total momentum of the two objects before collision is equal to the total momentum of that two objects after collision. Let's see one example here. Here you can see the two figures. First figure shows before collision condition and second figure shows the condition of after collision. These are the two objects. You can see one object which is in yellow color and one object which is in purple color. This object having mass m1 and velocity u1, this object having mass m2 and velocity u2. Before collision, that means when both the objects are colliding, you can see the arrow direction. See, in this figure the direction is like this and in the second figure which is of after collision the direction is in opposite way. Why? Because when both the objects colloid, due to the mass of both the object and due to the velocity of that object, it goes in opposite side. But what the law states, that total momentum before collision is equal to total momentum after collision. So it will be very much clear from the figure. And this is the statement of law of conservation of momentum. So these are the three conservation laws which are very important while we are studying three different levels of transport phenomena. What are the conservation laws? Law of conservation of mass, law of conservation of momentum and law of conservation of energy. So these three conservation laws are very important while we are studying the macroscopic level, microscopic level and molecular level. Fine. I hope the three conservation laws are clear to all. So let's move to another topic which is vector and tensor calculus. You have already studied this concept in your subject mathematics. I am just quickly revising this. Three different types of physical quantities are used in transport phenomena. Scalar quantity. What is scalar quantity? It just gives you the magnitude. It does not give the direction. What are the example of that? Volume, density, mass, time are the example of scalar quantity. Next quantity is the vector quantity. Vector quantity are those quantity which gives you the magnitude as well as direction. Fine. What are the example of that? Force, velocity, torque, etc. These are the quantities which provides you magnitude as well as direction. Right? And the third quantity is tensor quantity. Tensor quantity provides you magnitude, direction as well as the plane in which it acts. The example, stress, strain, momentum, flux, etc. So, these are the three physical quantities. These quantities you have already seen in mathematics. Scalar quantity, vector quantity and tensor quantity. We are going to use the concept of this quantity in our next topic. So, this is about the vector and tensor calculus. Fine. So, in today's session, we have covered the conservation laws. Which are that laws? Law of conservation of mass, law of conservation of momentum and law of conservation of energy or heat. And next we have covered vector and tensor calculus. In that we have seen the three quantities, which are that scalar quantity, vector quantity and tensor quantity. Fine. In our next session, we will see another topic. I hope these topics are clear to all of you. Thank you.